Hello everyone and welcome back to Easy Dentistry, a channel that makes dental education incredibly easy. Today we will be studying the part 3 of denture-based materials. This topic, denture-based materials, is very vast. So we would be studying it in four parts, part 1, 2, 3 and 4, out of which part 1 and part 2 are already uploaded. Please find the link in the description box and watch those lectures first before watching this lecture. So in this lecture we will be studying the properties of denture based materials and various problems occurring in the denture based materials during processing, like the porosity, crazing and the recent advances. The porosity and crazing are very important questions which are asked in exams, both in the Viva as well as short answer questions. So watch this lecture carefully. Also, we will be studying about the denture cleaners, how to take care of the acrylic dentures. We will be studying about the resin teeth and one important topic of long answer question or the essay question, that is the comparison between the resin teeth and the porcelain teeth. So, without wasting any time, let's begin with today's lecture. But before that, please subscribe to our channel and also hit on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of the important lectures that we upload. So, starting with today's topic, the properties of denture-based materials or the denture resins, the monomer or the methyl methacrylate is a clear transparent liquid and it is volatile and it has a sweet odor. The melting point of monomer is minus 48 degrees Celsius while the boiling point is 100.8 degrees Celsius. The density of monomer is 0.945 gram per ml at 20 degrees Celsius. The heat of polymerization is 12.9 kilocalories per mole. The volume shrinkage during polymerization is 21%. While the polymer or the polymethyl methacrylate is tasteless, odorless powder and it is clear and transparent, but it can be pigmented. It is compatible with the dyed synthetic fillers. The physical and mechanical properties: the density of the polymer is 1.19 gram per centimeter cube. The compressive strength is 75 MPa. Tensile strength is 52 MPa. The strength of the self-cured resin is much less than the heat-cured resin. The strength is affected by composition of the material, the technique by which it is manipulated, the degree of manipulation, polymerization, the water absorption during processing, and also on the environmental conditions. Now, what is impact strength? The impact strength is defined as the energy absorbed by the material when it is broken by a sudden blow. Ideally, the denture-based resins should have a very high impact strength, and this impact strength is increased by addition of plasticizers. The impact strength of the self-cured resin is less than the heat-cured resin. That is, dentures made from the self-cured resin may break easily than those made from the heat-cured resin. Now, the hardness. The noob hardness number of heat-cured resin is 18 to 20, while that of the self-cured resin is 16 to 18. The modulus of elasticity is 2400 MPa. Now, talking about the dimensional stability, a well-processed denture has a good dimensional stability. The dimensional stability is a balance between the processing shrinkage and the water absorption. Now, this processing shrinkage occurs due to two reasons. First is the thermal shrinkage, which occurs on cooling, and second is the polymerization shrinkage. Now, what is the polymerization shrinkage? During polymerization, the density of monomer changes from 0.9 to 1.19 gram per cc, and this change in the density of the monomer results into shrinkage, which is the polymerization shrinkage. Now, the linear shrinkage in the denture-based resins is 0.53%, while the volume shrinkage is 8%. Also remember that the acrylic resins undergo water absorption. They absorb water and expand by 0.6 milligram per centimeter square. So this water absorption causes expansion, and this expansion may compensate for the polymerization shrinkage. So, coming to the thermal properties of the denture-based resins, the polymer is stable to heat. It softens at 125 degrees Celsius and it depolymerizes if the temperature is increased between 125 to 200 degrees Celsius. At 450 degrees Celsius, 90% of the polymer is converted into monomer. So, the denture-based resins have poor thermal conductivity. They have high coefficient of thermal expansion, that is 81 into 10 to the power minus 6 per degree Celsius. The color stability of the heat cure resin is higher than the self cure resin. Biocompatibility, completely polymerized material is very much biocompatible. Inhalation of the monomer is toxic. In some individuals, this monomer may cause an allergic reaction. Now, the adhesion. The adhesion of acrylic resin to metal and porcelain is very poor, so mechanical retention is needed, while the adhesion to plastic is good and acceptable. The shelf life. If the material is provided as powder and liquid, the shelf life is very sufficient, but in gel forms, the shelf life is decreased. Now, another important concept we will study here, which is asked frequently in exams, is the porosity in the denture base. The porosity are of two types, internal porosity and external porosity. Let us study each in detail. The internal porosity, as the name indicates, are present on the internal parts of the dentures. The internal porosities are pores or blebs, and these pores, they weaken the denture. Now, pores are areas of stress concentration. Suppose this is an area in which there is increased stress. So, when the stress is released, there is formation of an empty pore here. The stress is released, so there is formation of an empty pore here, which is called as the internal porosity. So, this internal porosity is mainly present in the thicker portions of the denture. What is the cause of this internal porosity? The vaporization of monomer, when temperature of the resin increases above the boiling point of the monomer, that is above 100.8 degrees Celsius, if the temperature rises, then it may cause internal porosity. Now, why this internal porosity occurs? On the surface of the denture, the resin is in contact with the investing medium, that is the gypsum product, stone or plaster. So, this heat which is applied is conducted from the resin into the investing medium. So, no porosity occurs. But in the inner portions or the thicker portions of the denture, this heat is not conducted from the resin to the gypsum product. This results into porosity. Now, how to avoid this internal porosity? By controlling the temperature of the curing cycle, you can reduce this internal porosity. The curing cycle should be carried out at 9 hours for 9 hours at 74 degrees Celsius. Now, what is the external porosity? As the name indicates, external porosity is present on the surface of the denture. It makes the appearance of the denture very unaesthetic, and due to which there is decreased oral hygiene due to presence of this external porosity. Now, this external porosity occurs due to two reasons. First is lack of homogeneity of the dough, and second is the lack of adequate pressure. Let us see how lack of homogeneity of the dough results in porosity. If the dough is not homogeneous, that is, certain areas of the dough, it contains more monomer than the adjacent area. Suppose these brown dots are the areas where it contains more monomer. So, the portion of the dough containing more monomer will shrink more as compared to the adjacent area, and this localized shrinkage results in voids formation. Also, lack of adequate dough. If very little amount of dough is taken while processing, then this external porosity may occur. And the shape of this external porosity may not be spherical. It may be irregular shape. If you have taken sufficient dough or not can be checked by using the flash. We have already discussed what is flash in the second part of denture based resins. So watch that part. Now, another important question asked in exams is what is crazing? Formation of surface cracks on dentures is called as crazing. These cracks may be microscopic or macroscopic, and these cracks result in fracture of the dentures. Cause of these crazing cracks are the mechanical stress, secondly, attack by any solvent or incorporation of water may result in crazing. These cracks they occur at right angle to the tensile stresses, and this crazing is the mechanical separation of the polymer chain, and they occur at right angle to the tensile stress. How to avoid crazing? By using cross-linked acrylics, crazing can be reduced. Also, using the tin foil separating media, crazing can be removed, reduced, and by using metal molds, the crazing can be reduced. Now, what are the recent advances in the denture-based resins? Modified polymethyl methacrylate, like hydrophilic polyacrylates, the high impact strength resins, rapid heat polymerized resins, and light activated resins are some of the recent advances in the denture based resins. In high impact strength denture resins, butadiene styrene, rubber reinforced polymethyl methacrylate is there. In fiber reinforced resins, there is decreased chances of fracture. In rapid heat polymerized resin, the resin is polymerized under boiling water for 20 minutes. All these advances in the denture resins are to increase the physical properties of the resins. Next important question, what are the denture cleaners? Wide variety of agents are used for cleaning the dentures, like the dentifrices, denture cleaners, soap and water, salt and soda, household cleaners, bleach, and even vinegar. There are two methods of cleaning a denture. First is the immersion of the denture in the cleanser. Second, by brushing the denture with the cleanser. The composition of these denture cleaners are alkaline compounds, detergents, they contain the flavoring agents and sodium perborate. Now, how does this denture cleaner act? When the denture cleaner powder is mixed with water, the perborate is released. This perborate, it decomposes into alkaline peroxide and nascent oxygen. And this nascent oxygen, it loosens the debris on the denture and thus cleans the denture. Now, the infection control of the denture can be done using ethylene oxide. Now, the care of the acrylic denture. How to take care of this acrylic denture? The dentures should always be kept moist because drying of the denture may result in dimensional change. Abrasive dentifrices should not be used for cleaning of the denture because they may cause scratching and wearing of the denture. Thirdly, the hot water should not be used for cleaning the denture, because by using hot water, the processing stresses can be released, resulting in permanent deformation. Now, let us see what is the resin teeth. When the polymethyl methacrylate is added with lot of cross-linking agent, this results in decreased crazing. The resin teeth are made up of polymethyl methacrylate polymer with lot of cross-linking agent. Now, let us see the difference between the resin teeth and the porcelain teeth, a very important question asked in exams. So, get thorough with it. The resin teeth have an increased fracture toughness, while the porcelain teeth have less fracture toughness. In resin teeth, there is decreased crazing, and in porcelain teeth, there is more crazing. Resin teeth can wear off easily, while the porcelain teeth do not wear off easily. Resin teeth are easily grounded, while the porcelain teeth are very difficult to ground. Now, the resin teeth do not produce any sound on when they come in contact with each other, while the porcelain teeth produce a clicking sound when they come in contact with each other. Now, dimensional changes are always present in the resin teeth, while the porcelain teeth are dimensionally stable. Resin teeth show increased flow, while the porcelain teeth do not. There is loss of vertical dimension in the resin teeth, but while using the porcelain teeth, the vertical dimension is stable. The resin teeth are self-adjusting, while the porcelain teeth are not. The resin teeth chemically bond with the denture base, while the porcelain teeth mechanically bond with the denture base. There is decreased abrasion in the resin teeth, while the porcelain teeth shows increased abrasion. So here we complete with the part 3 of denture base materials. The next lecture will be uploaded soon. The final concluding part of the denture base materials, where we will be discussing about the denture liners, tissue conditioners and maxillofacial prostheses. These are very important short answer questions which are asked frequently in exams. So watch all the 4 parts of denture base resins 1, 2, 3 and 4 in continuity. That's all for now. Please subscribe to our channel if you have not yet done, and happy studying.